What's going on, guys? Welcome to Garage 23, and today we're going to be showing you the easiest way to remove the bent valves from your cylinder head. So let's get started. Okay, so if you guys watched the last video, we determined that this K24 had some kind of event where it lost timing and the valves came into contact with the pistons. Just gave them a little, and they don't work anymore. We need to get them out of there and replace them with ones that weren't hit in the face. So I'm gonna show you the easiest way to do that. And I say easy as a relative term because the valves are between the engine and the block. So your baseline is removing the cylinder head regardless. The tool that I bought for this is gonna be the easiest, the most reliable, consistent way of replacing your valves. Because there's a few other ways to do it, but I found that they're just really tedious, and it's almost like you're relying on luck to get the valves back in to place properly. So I don't really like that. I've always wanted one of these tools, and Amazon just so happens to carry it. So this was about 50 bucks. There's a cheaper version. I just got the most expensive one because this version of the kit lets you do this whole process with the cylinder head still on the vehicle. The reason why that's beneficial is if you just needed to like replace your valve seals and you don't want to take the entire cylinder head off the engine, you can use this kit to basically connect your air compressor to your spark plug well and thread it in, and then you feed pressurized air into the cylinder, and that will keep the valves shut against the cylinder head while you set up the rest of this, and then you're able to compress the spring without the valve moving, and then you can replace your valve seal or even your valve spring retainers, all that stuff, if that's what you needed to do, without taking the head off. So that's a big plus, and that's why I got this kit. But for the purpose that we need it, to replace the valves altogether, you are, like I said, gonna have to take the entire cylinder head off of the block. But I'm gonna show you guys how to check if your valves are even bent or even if they're just not sealing right. First, take the valve cover off and drop all the stuff on the floor. Then get your cylinder head off. And in our case, there's visible damage, right? Like it's still kind of minimal, but like we showed in the last video, the valves aren't seating against the valve seat all the way. And we can illustrate that a little better by checking with water. As you can see, it just pours right out. So I actually already replaced one of the valves on this end over here, and we can do the same test. See if I can pour down one side without spilling it everywhere. Yeah. So like right here, the valve on your left is still bent, but the valve on your right, I replaced with a not bent one, and there's water in here right now and it's not leaking out. As you can see right there, we're holding the entire amount of liquid in that chamber without any of it leaking out of the front. So that tells us that valve seat is still good, that valve is good, which is surprising because I got these not bent valves from the junkyard from a regular K24 out of, you know, whatever Accord, because I heard that they were all the same. And yeah, this kind of proves it. They're all the same. This is the RBB cylinder head. So this is like the cream of the crop as far as K24 heads go. And this valve is out of just your basic Honda Accord. So that's good to know. If you bent your valves, you can literally just go to junkyard and grab another set for like, I think I paid like $8 for these, which is a lot better than, I think Honda charges $35 each. So yeah, with 8 valves, that's not cheap.
It's okay. I don't have any money today anyway.
And even if you were to go with like aftermarket replacements, like SuperTech or something like that, you're still in at a couple hundred bucks. So So it depends what you want to do, right? If you're going for like a super high horsepower build, yeah, you might want to just go ahead and do that anyway. If you just want, you know, a nice quick daily driver with a couple hundred horsepower, this will be just fine. So the fact that this first valve is sealing so well is what prompted me to just get this tool and just replace them all and see if we can get lucky and just not have to do a valve job on this, because that would be phenomenal. We're probably still gonna have to deck the head, even though it should be straight. We removed it properly, so it shouldn't be twisted, but I don't have the tools to check for flatness on a cylinder head, so it's just good practice to get a nice little skim off whenever you take a cylinder head off, if you're able to. If not, you can risk it, it'll probably be fine, but I think we're just gonna do that anyway. So now, just pour all that water out. And then we're gonna need to hold our cylinder head back to the block. So grab a couple of the head bolts and thread them in. This doesn't need to be super tight, it just needs to not move around. Then we're gonna get our tool
and start setting it up.
All right, so the kit comes with these brackets, and you have to find somewhere to bolt these on the sides of the head. And it comes with some bolts, but it might not work for your particular application. Like, it didn't work for us here. These are a little too long and they don't snug the bracket down enough. So I had to find some bolts of my own that'll work. And same thing on the other side. And you have this little bar that goes across the whole thing. And there's obviously a few different spaces where you could put it depending on your needs. We're gonna try that first. Then the next pieces go together like this. This is the part that presses onto your valve retainer. And then this is the lever arm. Also has a few different spots, depending on where you need it. I'm not sure where we need it. Yeah, so it has the pin to hold it together. And then from here, you should be able to press down on your valve. So obviously we need something to hold the valve from going all the way down with the retainer and everything. In our case, we can turn the engine to bring the piston up to meet with the valve, just like they already have. So they're already pretty well acquainted. So we're just gonna do that same process, and that should let us compress the spring and get the locks off of the retainer without the valve moving. Okay, so right there, the number one piston should be at the top. So now if I press down again, the valve should move a little bit, but then it should stop because it's hitting the piston, and we'll be able to get our retainers off. And I need something else to grab those. Okay, so I got a little pen magnet, and I'm gonna press down on the valve again. This thing's pretty hard to press down. So there, see, we got our locks off of the retainer. Now if I release, the whole spring is no longer attached to the valve. Ta-da. So now we just gotta repeat that 6 more times. Then make sure not to lose these. Okay, now we got all the retainers disconnected from the valves themselves, so we can remove each valve spring and set it aside. I always keep everything exactly where it came out of, like keep it in the same order, don't like mix parts around, because you gotta remember all these parts have been together for like in the case of this engine, like 60,000 miles. That's, you know, thousands of revolutions back and forth, you know, getting acquainted, getting to know each other, getting to know the other's family, getting to know their dog's name. And if you start mixing them around, their engine might not work as it was intended. So always keep all your pieces in order and keep track of exactly where they came out of. So like in our case, I put all the retainers in our little box here. So those retainers went with that spring. These retainers went with this spring. So I mean, as long as you know what order they're in, that's all you need. I mean, unless you work in like some kind of shop where you're doing something and somebody else is gonna finish it, and then you need to make it clear to someone else the order everything went in. But even in a shop, you wouldn't do this between two people. You typically start this and finish it yourself, so shouldn't really be an issue. Now we can get the cylinder head off again by removing our head bolts. Garbage. Actually, now we can see just what's wrong with the valves. This is a good one. This one, not so much. All right, so now we can put our new valves into the cylinder head. And like I said, I got these at the junkyard for $8 or something like that. They charge like a dollar something per valve, which is fantastic. And go right back in place just like that. So also, obviously I can't know which, I mean, I probably should have kept these in order of what cylinder they came out of at the junkyard, but it's not really gonna matter because this is a completely different cylinder head too. And that's the only sketchy part of this is that, like I said, these parts aren't acquainted together. So like these valves weren't in the cylinder head to begin with. But like I said, I replaced this first one and it looks really good. So I think it's worth a shot to replace all of them and see how we're doing. All right, now we're ready to try and put the springs and retainers back on. Pretty much the same process as before, just more tricky because now we have to hold the spring compressed by force and delicately put the locks back onto the retainers without everything flying off on your face. So that's gonna be fun. But like I said, this is the easiest way to do this. The other way is like one of these, actually I think this kit comes with it too. Kind of like this sort of setup. So like, you'd have a tool similar to this, and then you'd put this over your spring with the retainers and stuff. And then you just basically like hammer it and hope that both the locks came loose and get stuck in a magnet that's usually in here. And then to put it back on, you basically got to do the same thing. Just put the magnets in place or the locks in place and just keep hammering over and over again until, like I said, you get lucky and they both happen to fall right into place perfectly. That's just really annoying and it takes a while and yeah, it's just not consistent. So this is the easiest way to do it by far. So like I said, this is gonna be the same valve that was in here to begin with. And then along with the same locks. Also, there's actually another type of tool too that can compress the spring for you, but it's kind of like a big C-clamp. And it requires the head to be completely out of the car, like on a bench. And then one end of the C-clip goes on the valve face itself. And then the other half will be like our tool and it'll press on the spring and you kind of like clamp it together. That one's kind of easier in the sense that you don't have to hold it down by force and the clamp kind of keeps it compressed for you. But like I said, with that tool, the cylinder head has to be removed from the vehicle. It has to be like on a bench. So that's not really what I was looking for. And that's the reason I got this tool. Actually, we need to put the head bolts back on so we don't flip this whole thing onto the floor. Okay. Now. No. And that's why a machine shop would charge you like 500 bucks to do this. Alright, I'm gonna try a different method with these little tweezers. Let's see if this works. And so the tricky part of that is getting both of them in at the same time, because when you're pressing on the spring, it tends to like move back and forth a little bit, and that can kind of press the opening against the neck of the valve, and so that doesn't leave enough room for the other lock to get in place. So that last one, I got it to work by making the top go in first, and then that leaves room at the bottom for the other one to fall in place. So let's see if that works more than once.
Up.
How do you have patience for this?
Can you keep shook it out?
All right, that was very easy once you have another set of hands to help you. Now for the moment of truth, let's test all the valves and see if we're that lucky that they all seal perfectly. Okay, so now they're all closed at least. I'm out of water, but apparently the exhaust comes out of this port. Oh, I think this is for EGR, I think. I don't know Hondas, but that's the only reason I could think for the exhaust port to be tied into the side of the head. So that's probably why we're getting water leaking out of here. But we're still getting a little bit of leaks out the front. So if you guys can see those tiny little drips, that's the valve not seating perfectly. Although that amount is, that's very small. Honestly, I didn't clean the valves. I probably should have cleaned them. Cause there's probably like little bits of dust or something. That would have been a smart thing to do while everything was apart. It's better than it was. All the water isn't pouring straight out. So, next thing to do is get the sink to the machine shop and have them resurface it. And I'll probably have them just double check this and see if this is acceptable as far as like valve leakage goes. Might just have to clean the valves and take them off. Don't really want to do that, but that's going to do it for this episode. And this is basically how you replace valves in any cylinder head. Basically any overhead valve engine is going to be pretty much the same way. So this same process will still apply. And granted, if you had brand new valves, this would probably go a little better for you. We just used junkyard valves, and that's about the kind of result we got. So thanks for watching this week. See you guys next time. Remember, always do your best.